Hello, and welcome to week two of our Teen Time Crafts at Finkelstein Memorial Library. I'm Dianne, and today we are going to make a paracord compass bracelet. These are included in all of your kits. It looks just like this. We're going to go ahead and open this. All right. There are, of course, a set of instructions. You can keep these for reference, just in case. Your kit should have also a little compass, a buckle, which we're going to go ahead and unclip by squeezing the little sides, and it comes right apart. And you should have two different cords in this little bundle. Alrighty. You should have one long camouflage colored cord and one shorter solid green cord. If you've made a paracord bracelet before, this kit is a little bit different because there's two cords. Usually there's just one. Okay. So for the moment, just set aside your solid green cord and just take the camouflaged one. Find the center of it if you can by matching the ends together. Great. Okay, so we're going to take the double-ended piece. And we're going to put this through the top. We're just going to put both ends through. Normally, when you're doing this, you put the loop through first, but it's not going to fit through the buckle. So we're going to do this. Okay. And then take your little ends and put it right through the loop and pull it tight, just like that. Now these cords have a lot of little kinks in them, so you'll probably have to straighten it out. Okay. Next, go ahead and take the shorter green cord. Once again, find the center, match up the ends. This is significantly shorter than your other cord. That's okay. It should be. All right. And we're going to also feed these threads through this second loop right over here. I don't know if you can see this. Oop. Okay. Try to keep this one as even as possible. And we're going to pull this as tight as we can. Okay. By the way, if your kit is missing any pieces, please contact the library. Feel free, let me know. We do have some extras kicking around. Okay. So now our one-sided buckle has four strands hanging from it. Now this is not included in your kit and it's not necessary, but it is helpful. If you want, you can also grab a piece of cardboard and some scotch tape. And it is helpful if you just clip or tape, rather, the end of your buckle to this board. Alrighty. Okay, like so. All right, so now what we're gonna do is make a series of knots down the center. I think I read they're called cobra knots. Interesting. And we're gonna start working left to right. So basically, we're gonna make the same knot all the way down, but we're gonna alternate sides. Left, right, you get the idea. About halfway through, we're gonna pause and put in our compass. Okay. Tricky, okay. So we're gonna start on the left-hand side, and we're gonna loop it over the top of those two middle strands, which are crooked. We wanna make sure these are lying flat. Okay, now we're gonna take our second strand and put it right over the top just of this other camouflaged strand. Now we're gonna take this top one and we're gonna put it right behind these two solid color strands to make a knot. And then we're gonna pull it tight. I'm so sorry, you guys. It's impossible to hold this up and show you at the same time. And I just lost my knot, so we're gonna do it again. Okay. All right. So I'm gonna take the left loop, put it over the top. So I have my loop on the left here. I'm gonna take my right and put that over the top of that left loop. And then, okay. And then I'm going to put this behind the two solid color loops and pull. So basically, you're just making a knot with those two cords right in the middle. So you can see, I'm just tightening the knot here. So I'm gonna bring that all the way up to the very top, and I'm gonna tighten it as I go. The tighter the stitch, the neater your bracelet will look. Okay, so I'm gonna do the exact same knot, but on the other side, I'm gonna start with a loop to the right first. Okay, now I'm gonna take my second strand and put that over the top of this side. And then I'm gonna reach behind here, and that tail is gonna go behind those green, solid green threads. Okay, and then we're gonna pull it tight. I'm gonna have to lay this down flat so I can see what I'm doing, but I'll show you as soon as it's done. Okay. All right. So it's hard to see in this light, I am so sorry, but we have a little bit of a pattern coming here. So you're gonna keep doing the same knots all the way down, left to right. So we just did two. So the next one should be a left-hand side. So we're gonna loop it over the top, cross our strand over the first one, and then pull it behind those two solid green threads and pull. You want to make sure that the two solid green threads lay as flat as possible so you get a nice even stitch. It is not easy with this set because they've been wrapped up so tight for so long. They are full of kinks. Just do the best you can. Okay, so this next one is a right-hand knot. So again, we're taking our loop, the right-sided loop over the top. We're pulling that second thread, the camouflage thread, putting it right over the left-hand side, and then we're pulling it up and through and behind those two green supports. Okay. So we're still continuing. We have many more stitches to go before we're done. Don't worry if you make a mistake. It's really, really easy to remove one of your knots. Goodness knows I've done it a few times already. And we're just going to continue down a bit until it's time to show you how to put the compass on. Okay, so check and make sure your stitches are nice and tight as you go. And feel free to remove any stitches, or knots rather, that are maybe in the wrong direction or just mistakes in general. Okay, so we are roughly halfway down right now. Lighting is terrible, I'm so sorry. Okay, so you can tell that we are about halfway down our strands right now. So we're gonna add the compass part. So it should be, the finished product should look a little bit like that. It's about halfway down. So it is really difficult to thread all four of these through at the same time, so we're not even going to try it. We are going to go through and just take the two short strands first because they're the easiest to work with, and turn your compass sideways. Now the bottom bit of the compass is kind of rubbery, so it's easier to work with than the clasp was for the bracelet. Okay. Just make sure they're at least lying flat. Right, you can see this. We just have the two threads lying flat right through the center, but notice I have not moved it all the way up yet because we still have two more threads to get through there. I would try one thread at a time for these. And again, I would try to keep these lying as flat as possible so it's comfortable and the compass looks okay when it's all put together. Okay. So we have all four through right now, and I'm just going to pull them all tight. And then I'm going to move the compass all the way up so that it sits right underneath that last knot, just like so. Okay. From here, you're just going to keep adding more knots, just like before, same knots. And once again, we're just going to start with the left-hand side. So make your, let's see if I can do this holding it up now. So make your left knot, left side loop. The right side should be dangling down just like this. And then we're going to take that right strand and pass it behind just those two green loops, like so. And then we're going to pull it into a knot and all the way up. Okay, and then on the next side, we're going to make our right side loop, put one strand down over the top of the first one, and then pass that strand behind the two, it's getting away from me, the two solid green strands. Okay, and then just continue with the same pattern all the way to the end. Now the closer you get to the bottom, the trickier it's going to be to get all of your solid green threads to lie flat, unfortunately, because it's the end. Just do the best you can. Okay, so when you get down to near the end, don't forget to leave enough room so that you can make knots to tie this little guy. So don't braid all the way to the end. I just said braid. Don't make knots all the way to the end. Okay, so We got these kits off of Oriental Trading, and there is a video that they have done to show you how to make these, but it's it goes by really, really quickly, and it, at the end, it looks like they just used simple knots to connect this. Normally, when you're making a paracord bracelet, and you have these little stray ends on here, you melt them with a heat source, but we're not going to give you a lighter in your little kit. So you can try to tuck your ends in so that they look okay. I left mine a little bit too long here, but just to... Oh, one thing to keep in mind when you are adding the second part of the bracelet is to make sure we're going to disconnect this here for a minute because we don't need it right now. Okay. You want to make sure that both ends face the same direction. You'll notice they have a tiny little bit of a curve to go around your wrist. So just make sure everything lines up before you tie it off. Okay. So, in this part, the compass is facing up, and our little clasp is sort of curved. Okay. So we're going to go through and thread the two green ones first. And then we're going to try to thread through these two. Now, you do have printed instructions in here. But it's not very clear on how to end your bracelet. So, we're going to use the tips from their video and just try a simple knot. At this point, you can also fit it around your wrist and make sure that it fits you. The last time I made a power cord bracelet, it was way too big. Actually, this one's pretty big. Okay. I'm going to move this down. Now, because you're able to make really thin, really thick knots with this, if you do a simple knot at the end of your cord, it won't fall through, but it will make the bracelet lumpy. It's not gonna lie flat very well. I did watch another video where they recommended just tucking the ends in, so we're gonna try that and see how it works. So far, this is working better than I thought it would. Okay. Okay, if you do choose to use a pair of scissors and cut the ends of your cord, then I do recommend using some sort of heat source to melt the ends and keep it from fraying on you. All right, clearly this needs a little bit more tucking. Okay. All right. So it is possible to, well, this piece needs more tucking, but the other one looks okay. It needs a bit of work. but it is possible to not have to actually cut your cords if necessary. Let's see if we can try this on. Okay, so there you have it, a compass paracord bracelet. It's too big for me, I should have measured first. but it's nice to know that you don't have to cut the cords if you don't have the means to do so. All right, I hope you enjoy that. Join us next week when we do some basket weaving. All right, thanks so much.